muscles sweeping down and about. Your posterior and anterior view, that basically means back and front. For example, this group of muscles is called your hamstrings. The semimembranosus is located on the medial side of your posterior thigh. The semitendinosus is located on the lateral side of your posterior thigh. And the bicep femoris are located in the middle of the muscles of your posterior thigh. Those are the muscles that make up the hamstrings. Different types of muscles. First type of muscle is your skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscles cover your skeleton, giving your body its shape. They are attached to your skeleton by strong springy tendons or are directly connected to rough patches of bone. They are visibly striped muscles, this is because they consist of tons of muscle fibers inside. Skeletal muscles are also under voluntary control, which means you consciously control what they do, which basically means your nervous system has to make them work. Nearly all our body movement is caused by skeletal muscle contraction. Your skeletal muscles function almost continuously to maintain your posture, making one tiny adjustment after another, keep your body upright. Skeletal muscle is also important for holding your bones in the correct position and prevent your joints from dislocating. Functions of the skeletal muscles to reduce movement, maintain posture, stabilize joints, and to generate heat. Examples of skeletal muscles are all the muscles I showed on the previous diagram. For example, your biceps, triceps, deltoids. Second type of muscle is your smooth muscles. Smooth muscle is found in the walls of hollow organs like your intestines and stomach. They are visibly smooth muscles, which is why they are known as smooth muscles. They do not have fibers running through them like skeletal muscles. Smooth muscles are involuntary muscles. This means they work automatically without you being aware of them. Basically means you don't have to make them work. Smooth muscles are involved in many important functions of your body. For example, the muscular walls of your intestines contract the shrew through your body. Other functions of the smooth muscles are to aid digestion, extract nutrients, break down harmful drugs and poisons, such as alcohol, and remove waste from your blood. Examples of the smooth muscles are the liver, kidneys, stomach, intestines, bladder, and the eyes. And the last type of muscle is your cardiac muscle. This type of muscle only exists in your heart. Your heart is made of cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle is involuntary. This means that it works automatically without you being aware of it. However, unlike other types of involuntary muscle, cardiac muscle never gets tired. It works automatically and at a constant rate. The function of the cardiac muscle is to contract, squeeze blood out of the heart and other types of muscle, the via arteries, then that is to allow your heart to fill back up with blood. Functions of the muscular system. The main function of the muscular system is to provide our bodies with movement. These are all the different types of muscle movement. Antagonistic pairs, agonists, antagonists, fixator synergists, and the different contractions, isometric, concentric, eccentric, and isokinetic. The first type of movement is the antagonistic pairs. Antagonistic pairs consist of two muscles, agonist and the antagonist. As a sporting example, I've chosen the bicep curl. This is stage one of a bicep curl. In stage one, in the bicep curl movement shown in the picture, when the agonistic pair contracts to lift the arm up, the agonist becomes what we call the prime mover. This means that it's the main muscle causing the movement. In stage of the bicep curl movement, the biceps are the agonist because they're the muscle contracting to pull the arm upwards when the agonist is contracting. The agonist, the triceps in this case, is relaxing although it is still under tension. Stage two of the bicep curl. In the second stage of the bicep curl movement, as shown in the picture, when the antagonistic pairs contract to pull the arm back down, the agonist then switches and the triceps become the prime mover. When the agonists, the triceps, are contracted to pull the arm back down, the agonists, in this case the biceps, are relaxing although they are still under tension. Fixators and synergists. Synergists and fixators are the muscles that help the antagonistic pair produce a more efficient movement. The synergist is always bigger than the fixator muscle, so it is able to support your body through the movement taking place. Your fix- During this